stories abound of good men laid low by the brutal indifference fortune can show. It raises them up to illustrious light before casting them into perpetual night. It's easy to say that the victim's to blame when it's just a pawn in a monstrous game. Brought low, though virtuous, steadfast and true, by the scoundrels whose company is thrown into. Life began for young Mike on the Isle of the Spud, his blood red and thick as the PI mud. He learned the rewards of an honest day's work, and learned not to judge, not to lie, not to shirk. It's the size of a man's heart that counts, not the size of his gut or his checking accounts. But Mike grew too large for a wee charlatan. He wanted to till more fertile ground. The bright lights and bistros were beckoning west. The big city would put young Mike to the test. Montreal, la belle dame, and then Parliament Hill were the Eldorados where Mike would nurture his skill. Food, fame, fortune, Mike always craved more, and he longed to parade through the red chamber door. Like a broken LP, reminding him what a great ally he could be. Yes, yes, Monsieur Duffy, but only after we amend the law of gravity. The Duff got this much desired post in the end. Stephen Harper, who made him a friend. And it was Stephen Harper, who made him a friend. But the Senate was nothing but a shabby old sty, a barn full of porkers in Savile Row ties. They grunt and they roll in the filth and the mud, and Mike dove right in with a sickening thud. Thank you. on behalf of the hill, and hardly at all as a PMO shill. Every meal I expense is on Senate affairs. I just happen to dine with Calgary millionaires. The Senate was pressured to take a firm stand. The price of my sins, a full $90,000. When the PMO flunkies quickly stepped in, the ones you can spot by their sharp dorsal fins. Nigel Wright had the means to cut my check and end this dreary slow motion train wreck. Mike dealt with the devil and sealed the deal. He doomed himself to a legal ordeal. In mixing with bandits, idiots, and thieves, this poor man was swiftly brought to his knees. Just like Lear or Hamlet or Oedipus Rex, no one can predict which man's turns is next. To write fortunes